first of all, let's introduce the track. So we have first this twisty bend under the coffee table, over the Catboy and Owlette masks, around the corner, past the tanks, and there you can see Romeo's lab toys and also Night Ninja's bus, around these twisty turns, up the end, up over the box, past Catboy, and now we've got our Rival Racers playset. Let's give it a test. Yes, here we go. And round the loop, you're going to have to watch out for those distractions and those dangers as you go past there. Down through the PJ Masks HQ tunnel, out the other side, and we're around. So all we need now is to get our racers. So first up, we've got Amaya. Here you go. And now she needs to get changed for her racing into her superhero Owlette costume. And of course, she goes for the red car. Here comes Greg into his transforming playset. Out and down as Gekko, of course. Which one's he going to go for? Oh, he's gone for green. And here comes... Oh, no! Night Ninja! What's he doing?
Where are the PJ Masks now?
Wait a minute. That's not Catboy. That's an evil Catboy. He's got black eyebrows and a black totem and a black stripes on his head. Night Ninja's pretending to be Catboy. I don't think Gekko and Owlette... No, watch out, Gekko and Owlette! It's not Catboy! Oh, no! He's knocked them over and rushed off. Come on, Gekko. Come on, Owlette. You've got to catch him. The evil Catboy's getting away. He's racing right round the circuit. Past the HQ. Come on. Oh, here they go. Here we go. Gekko and Owlette. They go really fast. Under the tunnel. Past the Night Ninja bus. Up the twisty turn. I can't see Catboy. Where is he?
He's going to chase him.
Oh, Owlette's got left behind. Here comes Gekko, round the corner. Yes, he's going to make it. He must be catching him up now. Catch Catboy. It's not the real Catboy. There he goes. Get him. Get him, Gekko. That's right, round the corner. Night Ninja Catboy is so fast. Come on, Gekko, you can catch him. Right, Owlette's turn. Let's see what you can do, Owlette. That's really fast. Past the tanks. Past the Romeo lab under the table. That's it, round the corner. Super fast now. You've got to get down past this HQ. Oh, you're still not catching him. I know. Let's use the rival racers. Oh, we just missed him. He got past. Let's try again. Set it up again for the next lap round. Here we go. One, two, three, go. Oh, we're so close. Try again. Here he comes round for the next lap. All set up. Oh, just over the top of him. One more time. Yes. Oh, he got away. Look at what happened. I hit him. And he kept going. Night Ninja Catboy is rather good at racing. Right. One more time. Let's get him. We've got to knock him off. Oh, whoa! We went straight through the museum doors. Look at this jump. We didn't get Catboy, but we did an amazing jump. Woohoo! Right, I think we need another plan. Oh, here comes Connor. He's got up. He's using the transforming playsets to get up Catboy's level to Owlette's level. Oh, he's looking around to see what's happening. He's trying to get their attention to tell them it's not the real Catboy. I don't think they realise. That's it, Connor. Wave. Tell them. Catboy's not Catboy, he's Night Ninja. That's it, he's waving. I don't think Gekko can see him. He's too busy racing. I think you'll have to do something else, Connor. This isn't working. Go back down. One. Oh, he's changed into Catboy. He's the real Catboy. This will sort it out. Where are you going? Up the HQ. Oh, he's waving from the HQ. Can they see him now? Owlette, Gekko, it's not the real Catboy you're racing, it's Night Ninja. They still can't see him. Ah, he's going back down. Where's he going now? Oh, he's on the track. Watch out, Catboy, you're going to get hit. Oh, what's he doing? Oh, brave Catboy. Stop, Night Ninja. Night Ninja, we see you.
PJ Masks always ruin all my plans.
And you're trapped. Come on, PJ Masks, let's go. While Gekko and Owlette and Catboy carry on the racing, we're going to have a look at the Rival Racers playset, and I'm going to show you nicely and slowly how to put it together and also how to put the stickers on absolutely right. Are you ready? So, I just need to calm down a bit after all that excitement of the racing. We need to concentrate and be quite organised. So lay all the pieces out. You've got the sticker sheet there and you've got the instructions there as well. You need to read the instructions before you put it together so you know how all the bits. The first bit to do are these loop-the-loop pieces. You put one into each side and you've got the little plunger. The plunger has got two little ears either side of it and that connects to the plunger track, as you can see that releases it when you press it. Then the next thing you have to do is find the connecting bits for either side of the plunger And that is so you can dry over sideways, so you can play with it in different ways, and then you can connect the loop bit. Now, I found this bit a little bit difficult. As you can see, I thought it would just clip together quite easily, but I couldn't get it clipped, and it took me a little while, so I checked the instructions, I put the button bit on, and what you need is a little bit more pressing. Make sure the little tabs go right into the slots perfectly, and then they're joined. It's also worth noting that once you put it together, you can't take all of the bits apart very easily, so you want to probably have some space to keep it up. That's what we're going to do. Put the green curb on, that's the loop round after the green, so it catches the car, and then you've got the jump piece. You put the museum doors there on the back, and you put the ramp at the back. Now, but I put the ramp on wrong at first, because you have to have a spacer so that the what is it? It's the night ninja bus, isn't it, that pops down there. You can see the owlet's just popped up on the green. You have to pop her down, and you've got the little bridge bit, but I put the wrong bridge bit in here, so I had to swap these two bits over, put that bit back over there, and then I could put the bridge on, and we were all straight. And then that's pretty much most of the build done. You've got these little bits to pop on here and over here. Get it into the dot. That's right. Now the next challenge. Whoops, I knocked the box off. The next challenge is to get the stickers. You've got a sheet of stickers here. It's worth taking some time. Now we're not watching this speeded up. I took quite a lot of time to do these stickers because once they're on, they're hard to get off, and you want to make sure that it looks brilliant. So here we are. The museum doors have stickers. The little Ninjalinos on the museum door. It makes it look really nice. Make sure the doors are flat as you do it. Take your time. If you're a bit younger, then maybe you want to get an adult or a parent to help you to make sure you stick them on right. You've got the museum windows there, left and right, and we've got the top window on the right and the top window on the bottom. Now, what's next? Oh, we've got Luna Girl. Now, I got this mixed up because I put it on the outside, but it's wrong. It has to go, whoops, out of the way, head. It has to go on the inside. And if you put it on the outside, it's back to front. So there you go. That is our Rival Races playset. It's all set up and ready to go, and we can give it a little try. Oh, that's pretty good. It does take a bit of practice to get it right through those museum doors. Let's have a go at Catboy. You have to press this down really hard. Make sure the Catboy is loaded in, but right back into it, and then you get enough power to put it right down the loop. It takes a practice again, but once you get the hang of it like that, and you can see Luna Girl popped up as Catboy went by. Now you can see here how we set it up with the rest of our race course. We've got the HQ there. And I'd love to hear how you plan to use your PJ Masks toys this year. Will you be making fun tracks like us? Will you be having races with them? Will you be using the villain vehicles? Will you be using that new Romeo lab or the Night Ninja bus? How will you play with them? Of course, there's also the transforming playsets that we used in this episode as well, and the different PJ Masks transformed into the characters before getting into the car. Will you be collecting those as well? So why don't we finish off with some of the footage of the racing that we didn't use in that main adventure with the PJ Masks. This one didn't quite work. Look, because Gekko goes up here. Oh dear, he falls off. Right, try again. Owlette and Gekko, take two. Oh, Owlette, you did it wrong. So it doesn't always go to plan, but by doing it again and again, we can make them work. And we see our great race. There goes Gekko down through the HQ, under the table, and around. This was a really good run. He was really quick on this go, and around, and then up, and then he's going to do a loop again. So there you go. That is our look at the Rival Racers playset in our race for PJ Masks. Let us know in the comments what you think of the PJ Masks toys this year. Are there particular ones you're going to be getting? Are you looking forward to more PJ Masks episodes? I know lots of you are asking about season 2, which I think is coming quite soon. Also, have you seen the new PJ Masks dress-up outfits? There's new deluxe outfits in t-shirt form this year. So that combines those sort of all-in-one suits, and they fit a wider range of ages. And they're really nicely padded. And also the masks this year on those deluxe PJ Masks suits and masks, the rubber inside is a little bit softer. And so my kids have been enjoying wearing them because it doesn't hurt their nose quite as much. So there you go. That's all things PJ Masks. We haven't got any time for any more. We better say goodbye. See you soon. Bye.